Alright, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to read off a Reddit post talking about how a landlord's been spying on a tenant's internet history and told them about what they were spying on. And I've seen this post come up a few times on Reddit now. And I figured it was finally time to make a video about it because I've seen a lot of these landlords try and pull this. I've also known personally of people that have had these issues or potentially almost ran into these issues. And I want to show you how to mitigate this problem. And also some things you need to be aware of, some traps with dealing with landlords that do this kind of stuff. So I know the post is a little bit old, 21 days ago as of the time of me filming this, but here I'll just read this off real quick and then we're gonna get into how to deal with this stuff. So it says, landlord openly reading off our Wi-Fi internet usage behind our backs. As the title says, my landlord was reading off about are there roommate's internet history, saying, oh, they spent this amount of time on Cornhub. Why would anyone need to spend that amount of time on that kind of website? And he mentioned this, or the person mentioned this, is one of the reasons they wanted to break the lease early, as they felt it was a privacy issue and also unprofessional. And it sounds like this landlord's got a lot of problems. I mean, there's a lot of issue if your landlord is spying on your internet history. And it sounded like this guy was making some pretty inappropriate comments. And then he said, oh, well, I need to be able to look through Wi-Fi history for the type of Wi-Fi that you guys have. And so this commenter said, it seems like it's not your typical household router and is more industrial. Yes, we'll get into that in a second. Is anyone able to make sense of this? I can't imagine why he would need to be monitoring our Wi-Fi in order for it to work. He does not need to do that. Even if he needs to be looking through it, figured I'd give him a little bit of benefit of the doubt for taking this a step further. Okay, so let's get into this. I didn't want to spend a bunch of time reading the post because there's a lot to unpack here. So let's go over to the fancy drawing that I made using my new, see if I can get it on camera here, my new drawing tablet. I keep telling you guys I'm gonna improve the quality of the content on this channel, and I'm slowly working towards it. I'll probably do a video about this tablet here further or more in the future, but for right now, I just wanna get into how to deal with this stuff. So first thing I'm gonna mention here is that when you're running into this kind of stuff, you need to leave the situation. Now, I realize that this might be kind of tricky depending on state to state, or, you know, depending on the country. You know, like if you're in Europe, I imagine the landlord-tenant laws are probably way different than they are in the States. But if you're dealing with a kind of landlord that's doing this stuff, there are a lot of other issues that are going to end up coming up. You know, it's the kind of thing where maybe they're sneaking into your apartment while you're at work and they're going through your clothes or going through your refrigerator. Or we'll get into this here in a second, having bugs and cameras planted around the place. The other thing is just avoiding this kind of stuff altogether. And I'm gonna get into that here in just a second, what I mean by avoiding. So let's get into how to work around this. First off, when you run into this kind of stuff, you need to replace the router that is in the apartment. So a couple of things on this. In this person's case, what they really need to do is just replace the router now, and that's probably going to trip some red flags with this guy, and he's going to try and argue it. And this is the kind of thing, if you took this to, let's say, an attorney, or to, I don't know if there's like states have like a rental board or landlord board or something like that through like a state government, if it got out that this guy was doing this kind of stuff, he would be in deep shit. And I don't care what anyone says, when you are a tenant, you are renting out an apartment or you rent out a house, it is completely unacceptable to be spying on your tenant. They rent that place out. The landlord has absolutely no business going through someone's internet history. And I think there's a pretty strong case there to say that there's at least some level of stalking going on. So here's one of the big reasons that you need to replace a router if a landlord already has one in the place. Now, for this person, like I said, they need to move out, but let's say you're moving into a place, there's no red flags that came up, but you see, oh, there's a landlord pre-provided. This is something that I had experienced before. Oh, you move into a place, there's a router, it's got Wi-Fi. all that kind of stuff. You can just hook your internet up to it and go. Here's why that is an issue and why you need to use your own. When you are setting up your network, so let's say it's got a Wi-Fi network. This is going to be one of the biggest red flags that I would see coming into an apartment. Is you go in and there's a router there, they've got a Wi-Fi network set up. Here's what they can do. They can set up things like IP cameras around the house in hidden places. And they could also set up bugs like recording devices, for example. Now, if people have never been introduced to doing like bug sweeps, I can tell you they are extremely time intensive. They require a ton of detail. You could rip everything apart. And the thing is, especially with the way modern technology is today, if someone's good at placing the bugs or placing the cameras, you would never even be able to find them. You could rip through everything. You could be tearing out drywall. You could be tearing clocks apart or going through entertainment centers, whatever, go through furniture, whatever. The issue with this kind of stuff is it's very easy to hide this stuff. And if someone's using it, they use the Wi-Fi network to basically operate the bugs, the audio devices or the cameras off of. When you go in and that device is already set up and it's got internet, for all you know, all those devices are recording, you know, your bedroom, your bathroom, your kitchen, your living room, all that stuff could be recorded and you wouldn't even know about it. And like I said, it doesn't matter how good of a bug sweep you do. They're extremely difficult to get done right. And like I said, if these people are, a guy like this is, if someone's going to this level of spying on people, there's nothing to say that they're not above going and setting up cameras. And the other thing is, even if they don't have any cameras set up now, what could happen later is if you're still using that same router, they go in at a later date, let's say 3 months down the road, while you're at work, they open up your apartment, they go in and they put a bunch of cameras, they hide a bunch of cameras. This is also one of the reasons, and I'll get into this in a later video, why I really advocate for setting up your own security system, not something like Vivint, but a security system where you have full control of everything. Because if someone comes in there, you know, especially like a landlord trying to sneak around and do something they shouldn't be doing, you can catch them. So we'll get into this more here a little bit later here in the video. Now there's a couple of solutions. Now I'm gonna mention these are temporary solutions only, is using a VPN or using Tor. Now there's some issues with this. First of all, you're just masking a problem. If you start using a VPN or using Tor, your landlord is still going to be able to see internet traffic, even though it may be encrypted. So you don't want him to be able to see what websites you're going to. So like I said, this is a stopgap solution. So let's say this is your computer, and I'm explaining this for people that don't have a lot of technology. If you do have a lot of technology, you know, this video probably doesn't really apply to you. I mean, you could still watch it anyway. So you've got your internet traffic going to and from your PC. Okay, this is your router here. Then that's going to and from the internet. So, you know, you've got Cornhub, you've got Google, whatever it is that you're searching, whatever your searches are for the day. So you've got all this traffic going back and forth. Now, they mentioned in the post that this must be some kind of industrial router. Basically, it's more of, would be more of like a commercial solution, like, or something maybe like OpenSense or pfSense, something where they have full logging to be able to see what websites you're going to, how long you're spending on those websites. It's not your typical consumer router. I know this from personal experience because I do the same thing with my network where I monitor everything that's going on, coming to and from my computers, all that kind of stuff. So here's why that's an issue. Why you don't want to rely on Tor or VPN. So you've got your PC here. You're communicating with the router. Now let's say you're running stuff through Tor. Okay, that's great, but you still have your entry nodes and your exit nodes. So your landlord is going to be able to still see that you're connecting to other people. He's going to still see how long you're using the internet for. He's going to see that you're running things through Tor. Some routers have the ability to block Tor altogether. So Tor may not even be an option if your landlord has that kind of stuff blocked off. Like I said, some routers, it's as simple as you click a button and then Tor traffic no longer works at all. The other thing is using a VPN. You know, one of the issues with that is you got to pay to hide your internet traffic from a landlord who is a busybody and wants to snoop through your personal life The thing is that traffic still has to go through the router, so your landlord would still be able to see, oh, well, he's connecting to private internet access or NordVPN. And then he's gonna think, oh, well, now they know that I'm on to them, now I'm going to mess with their internet. Or like I said, you know, when you're dealing with landlords like this, you gotta be really careful because they'll see something like this and they're gonna be like, oh, okay, well, now they're trying to work around me spying on them. So now I'm just gonna go in and set up hidden cameras in the apartment when they're not home. Again, I don't deal with stuff like this. I mean, like I said, this is a temporary solution only. Don't put up with this kind of shit. You can absolutely, there's a very strong case here for stalking because this is unacceptable for a landlord to be doing this. Now, one of the things that I saw people mention was, oh, well, you can just change your DNS settings. Actually, before we get into DNS settings, the other thing that you have to consider is, okay, well, let's say you are using something like, let's say Tor, for example. Well, you still have all your apps that are installed on your computer. So let's say you've got Steam, you've got, I don't know, whatever shit people are using these days. All of your apps are going to request connection separately. You know, maybe you're running a tablet with like Facebook or TikTok. All of those are going to show up as separate traffic, and it's going to show all this amount of data coming to and from Facebook, TikTok, all of that is separate. So again, it's stuff that your landlord would be able to spy and see, oh, here's what they're doing. And so one of the things that I saw people on that post comment was to change the DNS settings and basically go with encrypted DNS. Now, I've talked about encrypted DNS before. It's a great security setting, but it's not really going to help in this situation. You know, it's great to avoid things like cache poisoning or to have DNS filtering to filter out malware before you even get to a potentially infected website. But here is the issue with DNS. So like I've said in previous videos, DNS is basically like a phone book. It's how the internet works. So instead of you having to type in Google's IP address in your browser search bar, like, I don't know what it is, but let's say 10.10.10.10. I think that's actually their public DNS, but let's say for this case, you know, you wanted to go to Google. It's a hell of a lot easier to type in Google than it is to type in whatever IP address, because then you'd have to carry your own phone book to try and figure out what websites you wanted to go to. So the DNS system is really nice, but DNS does not protect you against stuff like this. So in this case, you have google.com. Okay, so this is, I'm gonna do, just kind of explain this DNS thing a little further. By the way, I really like this pen tablet. This is the first video that I've used it on, but I can tell this thing's gonna be super nice for making videos. So you've got, so here's how your DNS works. Again, if you're a super tech user, you already know this stuff. So with DNS, what you can do is you can go type in google.com. Well, if you run encrypted DNS, people are not going, you know, in this case, your landlord wouldn't be able to see, oh, well, he's going to google.com, it's going to be encrypted. But someone that's going to this level, they can still see all of the IP address because you cannot encrypt the IP address. So even though this is encrypted, people that are monitoring the network, and like I said, you know, I'm the same way. I monitor everything that's going in and out of my network. IP addresses are one of those things that I monitor. So you could hide that, oh, hey, I'm going to go to Cornhub and whatever, do slam in the salmon. So the thing is, though, is that in a case like this, the landlord could still see, and again, he's going to be able to figure out that you're using encrypted DNS, which is going to be a problem again, because then he's going to figure out alternate ways to come screw with you. You can still see the IP addresses because these are not encrypted. So changing your DNS does not work. So I'll wrap this up here. So in a case like this, if you end up moving, if you're looking at moving into like an apartment or a house and your landlord says, oh, the internet is provided, one of the things you're gonna wanna say is, oh, okay, well, that's great, but I've got my own hardware that I use. If they say anything like, no, you can't use your own solution, you have to use what's already there, that's a huge red flag. You should just move on and avoid them, because at that point, it's almost guaranteed that they are going to, at minimum, monitor your network activity, but at worst, they may have, like I said, listening devices connected to the Wi-Fi. They could have IP cameras hidden around the house that you would never know about, and it's, you know, obviously you could do, get like a scan tool and figure out what devices are around the house, but then you also still have the issue of like, maybe they have something manually planted that that they're just coming in and getting the SD card off of. And, you know, like I said, again, that's why I really advocate for having a security system that you have full control of, because if they come in and try goofing around, if they try sneaking into your apartment while you're away, the alarm's gonna go off, the cops are gonna show up, and your landlord can go to jail for trespassing or potentially even burglary because they did not give you notice and there was, you know, no legitimate reason for them to even be inside of your apartment. So as far as the avoidance goes, just make sure when you're looking at moving into a place, check and see if there's already going to be a router on site. And if there is, make sure you tell the landlord, hey, I have my own hardware, I'm going to hook up my own router. Do not use someone else's networking equipment. There are so many issues, security issues with doing that. I'm not gonna get into all of it on this video because this video is already dragging on, but that's how you avoid it. If you are already in a situation where you're dealing with this, let's say you're watching this and you didn't know about any of this stuff and you're like, oh shit. What you could do is just replace the hardware with your own, replace the router, modem, whatever. Use your own solution and see if the landlord says anything. And if they say anything, that's gonna be a huge red flag. Oh, I noticed that you disconnected the router. You need to hook that back up. Find a way to break the lease. There are ways to get around having to pay like an early termination or something like that when you have landlords doing stuff. I know it's probably gonna vary from state to state, especially depending on, like, some states have really good privacy laws and protections for tenants. Some probably not so much. But do not use someone else's router. It's a huge security problem and you cannot truly hide all of your internet traffic, even if you're using Tor or a VPN or you try and change your DNS to be encrypted. Anyway, that is going to wrap this video up. I've got some Linux content coming out a little later this month. I know I keep talking about it. It's on the way. I've been super busy working on stuff, and if you didn't see the community post, I am super spending a ton of time working on this project for the community that I talked about in that post. It's taking a ton of time, but I think the community is going to really enjoy this. And like I said, it's going to be free for all. There's no, you have to put in an email to access anything. You can access it whenever you want. It's free, open to all. It's going to be good. Anyway, that wraps the video up. I will see you on Monday.